The London Bible College is in the heart of London. This great city, which has had such a profound influence on many nations, was a symbol of liberty and victory to many during the last war. For the millions living in Europe during 1939 to 1945, the sound of Big Ben brought comfort and hope, even in the blackest hour. From the Houses of Parliament, built alongside the River Thames, there came a call during these war years that aroused the nations of the world to fight against oppression.
We shall fight on the beaches, we shall fight on the landing grounds, we shall fight in the fields and in the streets, we shall fight in the hills, we shall never surrender.
It was to this great city of London, symbolized in the minds of many by Tower Bridge, that William Tyndale came in 1524 to obtain permission to translate the Bible into English. He was curtly refused by the authorities, but a London alderman helped him to go to the continent where his great work, the translation of the Bible into English, was made. Although at first the translation was bitterly opposed and denounced by religious and secular authorities, the time came when the Bible gained a place in the national life. Here, in the city of London, steeped in history and colourful with pageant and tradition, there was established in 1943 the London Bible College. The college was brought into being by the united action of evangelicals of all denominations, in their desire to establish in the centre of London a large interdenominational college devoted to evangelical scholarship of the highest standard possible. The college is loyal, without reservations of any kind, to the complete trustworthiness of the Bible and its great evangelical doctrine. The college could scarcely be placed in a better position in the West End of London. It stands on a site within 2 minutes' walk of Baker Street Underground Station, and it is well served also by a number of different bus routes, as well as being within easy reach of all the main line railway stations. The college main building consists of a fine block of new premises in Marylebone Road. Here are found the college chapel, library, lecture rooms and offices. The building cost £240,000 and was opened free of any debt. Such is the blessing of God on the college that already it has grown to be the largest theological college of its kind in Europe. And extra accommodation is now needed in addition to the present building. The late Dr. E. F. Kevin was principal of the college from its inception in 1946. We thank God for the inspiration and achievements of our late beloved principal. The college began with 8 students in a borrowed building and grew to over 200 full-time students under his gracious leadership. This is the main entrance to the college building. The principal of the London Bible College is the Reverend Gilbert W. Kirby, M.A. Students come to the London Bible College from all parts of Great Britain and from overseas. The college is a residential college, but a number of students live out in homes in different parts of the city. Not only is the college interdenominational, but also it is international, with students from places as far afield as South America and Vietnam. The purpose of the college is to equip men and women with a scholarly and practical knowledge of the Bible, and to train them for the work of the gospel. Full-time training is provided for those who wish to be prepared for pastoral, evangelistic, school teaching, or missionary service. Let me invite you into the building and show you over the college. First, the entrance hall with the reception office. Facing you as you enter is the mural with the Bible in the centre. Underneath the Bible, these words are printed, "The entrance of thy word giveth light." On the right of the entrance hall is the general office, where all mailing lists are kept. From this office, each day, correspondence is posted to different parts of the world. Each morning, the college staff and students gather for prayer in the college chapel. Each Wednesday during term time, there is a preaching service. At least twice each term, the college holds a service of Holy Communion. Also, once each term, there is a quiet day, which is devoted to prayer and meditation. During the course of the quiet day, three preaching services are conducted in the chapel. This is one of the students' notice boards, where details of college lectures and other events which concern college life are brought to the attention of the students. These are the stairs leading to the other floors we occupy in the building. At the top of the stairs, we come to the Life of Faith lecture hall, library, faculty office, and principal's office. The Life of Faith lecture hall occupies almost the entire length of our top floor. This lecture hall can be divided into five separate lecture rooms. In addition to preparation for the college diploma, the college also prepares students for the Bachelor of Divinity degree and the Diploma in Theology. Since 1961, the college has been recognized by the Ministry of Education as an efficient establishment of further education. The college is essentially a training college. It is not an institution merely for instruction in theology, for the students are a body of men and women who have dedicated themselves to the Lord's service and whose characters are being developed to fit them for the special work for which God is preparing them. The vice principal of the college is the Reverend Dr. H.D. MacDonald, B.A., B.D. He is an Irishman from Dublin. Dr. MacDonald lectures in philosophy and historical theology. He is the author of a number of important volumes in the field of philosophy. In addition to the study of biblical books, there are many other subjects that are required by those who are preparing for the university degrees and diplomas in preparation for the ministry, or the teaching profession, or the mission field. Studies in philosophy, historical theology, prepare students to answer the questions regarding faith, which are being put to teachers and ministers and missionaries all over the world by young people who are in search of the truth. And so, students are expected to work hard at their studies. A course at the London Bible College makes heavy demands on the mental capacity of the young men and women. Dr. Harold Roden, B.A., is one of the resident tutors in the college. He lectures in the history of the Christian Church from its earliest days right through to this century. Dr. Roden also lectures in Christian ethics. One day, the London Bible College will be entirely residential, but at the present moment, about one-third of the students live in hostels. The Reverend A. E. Cundall, B.A., B.D., is a former student of the college, and after gaining his B.D. degree, he went to Australia, where he was pastor of a church. Mr. Cundall is head of the Old Testament Department. Assisting Mr. Cundall is Mr. Leslie Allen, M.A., who specializes in Hebrew and Greek. London Bible College is a missionary training college. All students are prepared for Christ's service in the world field, whether in this country or overseas. The supervisor of missionary studies is the Reverend John Savage, former General Secretary of the Evangelical Union of South America. The missionary atmosphere of the college is enhanced by the presence of students from overseas, and is further promoted by regular prayer meetings for Christian work in different parts of the world. The Reverend J.C. Connell, B.A.M.A., is the Director of Studies at the college. Mr. Connell guides the students through the intricate London University regulations. Mr. Connell lectures in biblical theology. The tutor's common room is alongside the Life of Faith Hall. Lectures begin at 9:15 and finish at 1:45 p.m. The afternoon is free for recreation, and after evening chapel at 6 p.m, students are expected to spend each weeknight busy studying. At mid-morning, there is a welcome coffee break. At the opposite end of the corridor from the tutor's room, there is the college library. This library has over 20,000 volumes in it. The college, however, is wonderfully situated in that quite near to it there are a number of first-class libraries to which students have access. It is planned to develop the college library in such a way that it will meet all the needs of graduates as well as undergraduates. The Reverend O. J. Thomas, B.A., is the college chaplain. Mr. Thomas lectures in English Bible and practical theology, and in addition directs college music. Music plays a great part in college life, with choirs and groups sharing in evangelistic campaigns and missions. The choir is also a good place in which to relax from the heavy strain of intensive study. The college has already broadcast on the Sunday half-hour program. Now we move to the basement of the college building, where there is a kitchen, dining room, and main common room. This is the student common room, but it is not large enough for all the college to use at once. We have a number of other common rooms in the hostels, which immediately join our new building. These common rooms are equipped with easy chairs. The caterer and housekeeper of the college is Miss Kathleen Owen. It is Miss Owen's responsibility to see to the day-to-day running of the dining rooms and hostels. In the catering department, there are 12 staff members, and the head chef is Mr. Peter Gator, and the assistant cook is Miss Priscilla Bridges. This department is on duty 7 days a week, from 6:30 a.m. until 8:30 p.m. During term time, the catering department prepares and cooks 600 meals a day and provides 350 snacks, 11s and afternoon tea. 5,550 pieces of crockery and knives and forks have to be laid on the tables and afterwards washed up, a formidable task day by day. Miss Owen and her staff have the meals, which are cooked to a turn, ready right on time. The general physical health of the college depends directly on the efficient work of the catering department. Each term, there is a bread and cheese lunch to which a visiting missionary speaker comes to bring before the college the challenge of the hungry millions. As you can see, this photograph was not taken on one of those days. Mr. Ronald Newman and Mr. Fred Thomas maintain the fabric of the college buildings. These men save the college a great deal of expense. Their task is to supervise installations as well as to maintain and repair equipment. This is Mr. Fred Thomas in the boiler room of the main college building. The boiler room is in the basement of the college and supplies all the hot water for the central heating and domestic use in the college. Immediately alongside the college are 5 hostels, 3 for men and 2 for women. The hostels are arranged in dormitories, with 3 or 4 students to each room. The real work of the students, of course, is done in private study and not in the lecture hall. So, When the lectures finish at lunchtime, with the afternoon being given to recreation, students are expected to spend about 3 hours each evening in private study. It is planned that one day, each student will have a private study bedroom of his own, but at the moment, the residential students study in the college new building or in their bedrooms. In the hostels, there are some offices. Mr. Tim Buckley is the Extension Secretary, and with Reverend O.J. Thomas, directs college evangelism, and his office is in one of these buildings. Mr. Buckley's work is to make known the ministry of the college with its day courses and its evening courses and its correspondence courses, as well as to encourage support in the work. To those for whom it is impossible to undertake a full-time course, there are two other methods by which the college is able to offer help. Firstly, this can be given by means of an evening course, which is available to all who apply, irrespective of qualifications. The student in a class has personal contact with his tutor, who can adjust his teaching to give special assistance, when necessary. And there is the opportunity to ask questions and to engage in discussion, which is invaluable. Evening class students come from all over London and the home counties. Those who attend evening classes are in the main Christians who are engaged in some form of Christian service in their church. In addition to the evening classes in London, we have an evening class branch in Liverpool, Manchester, and Dublin. Another method by which the college is able to offer help is by correspondence courses. The college correspondence course department is housed in one of the hostels. The correspondence registrar and office manager is Mr. John Potter, who is a former student of the college. There is a correspondence branch of the college in Cape Town, South Africa, and Melbourne, Australia, and courses have been translated into a number of different languages. There are, at present, over 80 courses in print. A correspondence course may be started by a student at any time and in any part of the world. Already, many thousands of students have registered with the college for correspondence courses. Full tuition as a correspondence student involves the submission of written work for marking. Some former students have prepared for full-time Christian work in this way. Correspondence courses of an elementary kind are available, as well as correspondence courses for the London University Diploma in Theology and the Bachelor of Divinity degree. There are also courses for the General Certificate of Education. The college is wonderfully situated, for not only is it in the heart of London, but immediately opposite our main building is Regent's Park. In Regent's Park, there are playing fields for cricket, hockey, rugby and football. There is a fine running track and also a large lake for rowing and sailing. Regent's Park has beautiful gardens, and it is a wonderful place in which to relax on a summer afternoon. Each summer, there is an inter-student sports meeting with running, jumping and relay races. Sports are arranged as a very good way of keeping fit. Students are encouraged to take part in recreational activities as the college course is intensive and heavy demands are made on the students in their studies. There is a London Inter-Theological Students Sports League where the colleges play each other in rugby, football and cricket. Practical work plays an important part in college training. Students share in open-air meetings, teach in Sunday schools, visit old people's homes, and other such activities. As the college is in the heart of London, there are ample opportunities for students to engage in practical work of this nature at the weekends. As a matter of fact, all students are in teams, which are based on churches, and so gain experience in a variety of different kinds of Christian work and witness. Evangelism is not confined to term time only. There are missions and campaigns and treks in various parts of Britain and Europe. During the Easter and summer vacations, students share in campaigns and have travelled as far afield as northern Greece. Here are a group of former students of the college. Over 1,000 have left us to serve God. They are ministers, teachers, evangelists, and missionaries. On a map of the world, it could be shown that former students of the college are serving God in areas as far afield as from Alaska to Zambia. Some are working in the sophisticated cities, while others are in the steaming jungles. Some are serving God in the high plateaus, while others are in the valleys. In addition to training for the ministry, the college considers the training of students for the teaching profession as one of its most important pieces of work, especially in relation to the schools in England. The vast majority of young people in Britain attend neither church nor Sunday school, and they are, therefore, not reached by organized religion. The only way in which the masses of young people can be reached is through the day schools, and Christians should urgently consider the teaching profession as a mission field of tremendous potential. Through the years, nationals from other countries have come to the London Bible College for training and have gone back to serve God among their own people. This is Sabod Sahu, who is in Orissa, in the Khond Hills in India. He is training pastors and evangelists. On the mission field today, the servant of the Lord Jesus needs to be one who can turn his hand to anything, whether it be teaching or preaching, building or dispensing. Although this has become an era of the specialist, versatility is still required in a missionary. Students who go from the London Bible College combine academic qualifications with practical abilities. The college trains students for the advanced studies of London University degrees. Many have gone on to qualify for the Master of Theology and the Doctor of Philosophy degrees. New Testament Greek and Hebrew are subjects that are essential for those who would translate the Bible into any language. A number of students are engaged in this vital ministry of Bible translation. Since the college began full-time training in 1946, some of the students that have trained here have gone into radio work, for on the mission field there are increasing opportunities for missionaries to broadcast, not only on radio, but also on television. There is a need for writers as well as technicians in this fast-developing field of Christian witness. A number of those who are qualified as doctors and nurses come to the college prior to going overseas to the foreign mission field. Our former students are found in all of the five continents. Thou, therefore, my son, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus, and the things that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same commit thou to faithful men, who shall be able to teach others also. Study to shew thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. The chairman of the London Bible College is Mr. Philip Henman. The college owes an incalculable debt to Mr. Henman for his wise leadership during these many years. Through the years, in fact, ever since its inception, the college has been guided in its strategy and policy by godly men. The governors of the college are well-known evangelical leaders representing different denominations, and it is their responsibility to plan the extension and development of the college, both at home as well as overseas. If you would like further details about the college, information about its courses, and ways in which you can help by becoming a friend of the college, write to the secretary, Mr. Donald Baker. The address is the London Bible College, 19 Marylebone Road, London, Northwest 1.